Hey everyone, this is Nicole from Kenhub, and in this tutorial, we'll be looking at some of the main joints in the human body. Joints are classified according to the range of motion they exhibit and the type of tissue that holds neighbouring bones together. When classifying joints according to the types of tissues holding the bones together, we can describe synovial joints, which are usually covered by a capsule and contain synovial fluids, allowing for large movements such as those of the hip joint on the right here. Fibrous joints, which unlike synovial joints, do not have a joint cavity and therefore are connected by a fibrous tissue such as the syndesmoses of the radio-ulnar joints. Fibrous joints don't allow for a lot of movement. And cartilaginous joints, which are joints that are connected entirely by cartilage, either hyalin or fibrocartilage. They typically have less movement than synovial joints and more movement than fibrous joints, and you can see an example of this on the right in the pubic symphysis. However, since most of the joints we're going to talk about today are major joints involving a large amount of movement, the joints we're mainly going to be focusing on will be synovial. Hi guys! As you can see, this video is a preview, which is reserved for Kenhub Premium members. Why not become one today? As a Premium member, you'll get access to this video as well as other videos, quizzes, articles, and our Atlas of Human Anatomy. Everything you need in order to learn anatomy in the most fun and efficient way. Join us and let's continue working together.